try to show here is what actually occurred, what happened on that 6th of June when the Nigerian Task Force invaded by Saifa Idowu's compound in order to assassinate him. This is the second attempt after the one that occurred on 2nd of December 2019. And the second one now is the one that happened on 6th of June 2021. This camera screen of various CCTV being placed in various angles. And then in my front here, we have a camera 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 7 faces of the camera placed in various angles. This camera footage shows clearly the bloody invasion of Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor's ancestors in the Anambra State on the 6th of June 2021. So this one is the camera behind the building. Camera behind this camera, okay, this one is camera one, this is camera two, then this is the main entrance. So as soon as they came in, they came, this camera captured when they were coming, and we have to reproduce it in the course of this analysis. So as soon as they approached the gate, trying to force themselves inside the premise, inside the compound, one of them probably discovered that the camera at the gate and broke it. That was when the camera stopped showing. Same happens to this camera too. But fortunately, before the cameras number one and two were tampered with, the cameras were able to capture vividly, clearly how they came in and how in the manner in which and the kind of ammunition they came along with and how sophisticated they were and also the formations of the JTF. So this camera, third camera, is the one within the compound. This camera shows clearly what the atrocities they committed inside Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor's house. It shows how his domestic staff were abducted, how his personal assistant Samuel Okoro, alias Biggie, this CCTV showed it, this CCTV footage showed it, was killed right inside the room. So there was no any form of, as can be shown through this CCTV, there was no any form of resistance from the domestic staff of Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor when they came in. All of them were standing still. Then they, before they, the few of them they were brought outside, they were standing still, there was no form of resistance. So the other person, the PEA, who was designed to be killed, as instructed and funded them to do, was also assassinated after injecting with lethal substance. This camera number three also showed when he was, the lifeless body was being evacuated from the premises. Captured him. You can see where they're moving the machine, but in the first area here. You can see him, can see them in their numbers. As if there's any war going on in a peaceful, in a lawyer's peaceful home. That's what's obtainable in Nigeria. See, you can see it. You can see them, you can see the soldiers. These are people who abandoned their duty post at Sambesa Forest to launch a bloody onslaught in a peaceful home. A barrister of international report. You can see it. You can see them. Moving. Okay. So you can see the soldiers. So nobody would deny the fact that security joint task force, heavily led by another direct command of AIG John Abang. It will also be brought to mind that John Abang was the person who killed Yusuf, the founder of Boko Haram. And on account of that death, Boko Haram has spread across the entire northeast, northwest, and all over the world, all over the north. Today, terrorizing citizens, terrorizing also the security agents. So because of what John Abang AIG did, and unfortunately, he's still serving today actively in the police, for Nigerian police force. So today, he sent his men to come to Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor on 6th of June 2021, house, a peaceful home, a lawyer's home, to kill him.
This is Nigerian army. This is soldier. Look at it very well. This is soldier. Look at him wearing army uniform. So now they are joint team. This one is police. This one is soldier. At least we've seen two soldiers. Yeah. This is Nigerian army. They are dragging the young man. Dragging him. The soldiers that took him out of the gate. They took him out of the gate. This is Nigerian soldier. You see the uniform? It's very, very obvious. See Nigerian soldier here. Yeah. Nigerian army.
You can see his brother, how the house been, the other brother, Joel Ejiofor, how he was being dragged to the car. See him. Harmless and innocent citizens. People, there was no any form of resistance. If you are investigating any case against a lawyer, he's not supposed to be extended an invitation. Or even come in the daytime, let's see people who are in his house. So but this time around, they choose to come at the wee hours of the night because they have some evil intention. They have an evil intention, evil design. And also, as you can see, they park their cars, about 15 Hilux vehicles, including a multi-snacker, about 5-3 kilometers away from his house. If before they came down to this place. So I know there will no traces of them will be covered by the camera. By the CCTV camera, which camera, so the camera can get their footage, the photo of the vehicle, the vehicle, the vehicle numbers, the type of vehicle they came with cannot be seen through that cameras. So they park about 3 kilometers away from his house, and threat to his house to commit this murder. So you can see what they are doing here. Camera captured everything clearly, so they can't deny this fact. You can see how they're coming in. You can see them moving in. At this point, they have killed Balasima in the first PA. If you watch closely, you see as we're about to evacuate him, like the lifeless body from the house. And as if that's not enough, they force the driver to hand over the car key, this Toyota camera car.
Okay, now, see what's going on. They've taken the vehicle. What they did now, they have to force and collect key from my sci-fi age of the driver. Yes. They collected the key from him, you know, to drive out. Remember, the car was there at the car park before they came in. Now they've taken the vehicle out.
This is a clear case of murder, a clear case of abduction, a clear case of stealing. You can see them. A clear case of stealing of cars. And in Nigeria, the vision, police would kill somebody in a peaceful home where they came on a supposed investigation or acted on a supposed false intelligence who never posed any form of resistance to them, who was harmless, then put the dead body inside his red car, took him away to a far distance and burnt him. The essence of burning this body is to destroy any evidence of what the kind of substance they use in killing him, to destroy it. So during the autopsy, post-mortem test. So that's what may be reason why, most likely may be reason why they burned this car. So this is a person who never posed any form of, you can see the driver being dragged on the floor of the compound. This is a person who never posed any form of challenge to the sense to it. You can see that how they were all abducted. Nobody was armed, nobody even raised a voice. So, and you can see them shooting, you can shoot, that's like, they're shooting gun now into the air. As I see the shooting gun into the air. To wait off any form of attack on them. So, but unfortunately, this is a peaceful home. This is not Sambisa Forest where they will see such attack. So you will see them now coming back to take over this, to drag away this car. So, and this car was suspended same night, burnt along. See this man that drove the car along with the PA, the level of the PA to Balasima in the phone at name in a national local government by Okacha Police Station. This car, as we speak today. It's still there. The skeleton of this car is still there. Up to date, this should be about 2 weeks or about after the incident, after the bloody onslaught in his home. No one of the police, you can see them driving the car. This is a car, hard-earned money of a lawyer. They damn drove this car away from the house. Not that this car is under any form of investigation. They went somewhere and burnt it. So it's important for the international community to look at this, investigate it. Thankfully, the foreign government have still invested on this matter and is getting it today. So it's important that the world watch what happened here, because this thing will go viral. And the identity of these people, this has learned to be in the course of time unveiled, because we'll capture them clearly more than this. So we call on international bodies to also investigate and request prevail on the government to identify these criminals in uniforms, and make them public, prosecute them accordingly. And that's what we are. The family of Balasima in the fall, and also Ivan in the fall is asking the world to do. You can see them driving the car. This car, driving away the car, had the money of a lawyer. Yeah. Not that the car was, it's subject of any investigation, and went outside and burned it. Today, the CP, Commissioner of Police Anambra State, made prompt contact with Barrister Jeffo on Sunday. The father, the state commander, was involved in the attempted assassination of his attempted assassination, and also the killing of his PA, or what the policeman JTF did in his house. So he was not involved, he was not informed at a point they are coming. He was aware of the operation. So neither was the area commander. Chair of this command was informed. So this operation was carried out under the direct order of AIG John Abang. So we are calling on the international community to look into this matter. As we progress, we are going to make more chilling revelations as contained in the footage about what happened in this house.